Hey, you guys, and welcome to That's Life, 27 years in the making and counting. I'm your host, MTR, also known as Matt Threat, and as always...
Patrick.
And Jose.
Hey, you guys, how you doing?
Pretty good.
Hey! Well, yeah, we forgot to Facebook Live this. Oh, well, I guess...
Well, I'm not Facebook. Oh, that happened. Discord!
Whoa! Chancy!
Oh my god, my voice is
gone. Oh man, I'm your host, MTR.
Hey!
Look, there were other things I did worse that we started off on the podcast and I'm not allowed to do anymore. I could steal stuff now.
That's mine.
This is not yours. You will die if you have one of these.
This is going south already.
What is that? Is that Instagram?
Yeah, it is Instagram. Oh.
Jose's officially came out of the closet. Make sure to watch this episode.
Yes.
Matt was in there with me.
Huh? Hey. It was a... What did Davey Havoc stay in? A clave. It was a nice clave.
I don't know what that is.
It's a closet cave, which is just a giant closet, but it's like big. That's the room he stayed in when... Probably throughout all the years of AFI up until... December Underground, essentially.
Cool. Now that we've gotten our AFI reference out of the way, we can start the show.
Dude, life is not life without AFI.
Yes, it is.
No.
Get things stopped.
Oh, there it goes.
I'm not going to lie. I just farted because I laughed. Like, when I laughed, I farted.
Well, have you ever sneezed so hard you farted?
No. I have. No, yes, I have.
Have you ever farted so hard that you laughed and laughed so hard that you farted?
No, but I did make a guy laugh so hard that he like shat himself once. That happened once. That was pretty awesome. And I recorded it too. You'll be able to find that recording of that.
Maybe it was during Taco Tuesday show. Or something.
We don't want to hear our voices. Don't do this. Don't
we do this all the time.
Don't do this to us. So, I came out.
Yes, you did.
I hate you guys right now.
You love us.
Zing!
There we go. This is why. Here's this. There we go. That's a lot louder. I don't know who messed with that. Maybe I did. But yeah, I came out.
Yep.
And announced to the world.
Yep.
I'm having a baby!
With another man. No, what?
Yes. It's a poop baby. It's just a nice giant poop baby.
They're turd tuplets.
It's not a tumor. It's a baby.
This thing's picking up everything.
I love my Larry. That's my favorite part of that movie.
No, but seriously, I'm having a baby.
Nice. Congratulations.
3 months.
How'd that happen?
When a man loves a woman.
you promised me no more singing.
I'm not going to go into the... No, I never did. You wanted no more singing.
All right, I promised me you wouldn't sing anymore.
Yeah, you promised to try to make me stop singing. But yeah, 3 months, I found out on New Year's Eve, and it was very interesting because I was like, you're fine. You're missing your... It's cool, dude. Like, it's just... It's a little late. It happens. Look, pee on the stick... And everything will be fine. It's going to say no. And then, like, it's like, yes. I was like, oh. Well, all right.
Did you pee on the stick?
Yeah.
No, I didn't pee on the stick.
Then it's not official.
Mm-hmm. It's only if I pee on the stick?
Yep. Everybody knows.
Really?
Yeah.
This is what they teach you in sex ed?
No, science.
Get out of here, dude. I heard if a guy pees on the stick, it comes out positive every time.
No.
Rat house tries.
No, if it comes
I'm okay
out,
with that. I'm no, okay
no,
with that.
No, that's seriously
what,
bad though.
What like, happens if the person comes out and says no then? Like, what are you like?
Everyone has to do it.
No, it's
science. We got science.
No, there was an actual thing where a guy he pissed on the pregnancy test just to fuck around and it came out positive and he posted it up. Some guy's like, no, dude, you better go to the doctor and get checked out. And it came out that he had testicular cancer.
No.
Yeah.
Rat House doesn't try.
well, Rat House tries, but extremely scared of the results.
Not doing that on video.
I'm scared to take any of those kind of tests.
By the way, you guys, we are... Hey, everybody in the studio audience, shut up. So,
our audience is getting bigger from week to week. I like
yeah,
this.
I know. No, I don't.
I love it.
It's a laugh track, and we have the applause and the awe, and those are the only two things.
If it was a laugh track, you wouldn't have to tell them to stop.
Well, we were doing our paranormal podcast, and we had a laugh track. We're like, what's so funny? Like, oh, great, somebody died. Real funny, guys. I break them at least once an episode. It's awesome.
Just a heads up, you guys. We are sponsored by Audible, so go ahead and go to audibletrial.com/rathouse, RETTHAUS, and try out Audible 30 days. You get a free book and all that good stuff. I'm still listening to the Carlos Santana book.
I thought you were listening to What to Expect When You're Expecting.
No, I want to read. What's the one from Daddy Daycare where it's like, it's not about Spock, but it sounds like it's about Spock. It was like trekking with something, and it was like, it's not about Spock.
Click the cricket sound. Fuck,
I know, right? I don't know which one it is. I'm just going to hit something. You're fucking hot.
That was beautiful.
I hate you. Nah. Anyways, so go ahead awesome. And go to audibletrial.com/rathouse. Shout out to Grown Up Not Grown Old Podcast, Twitter and Complex, that hashtag show, via YouTube, Geek Speak Show, Third Party Controller, Bats Podcast, and Shangri Live. Go ahead and download Lyft. Use our promo code RHP, and you will get 10 rides, $5 off. And as well as go ahead and check out Geek Fuel. We have our Geek Fuel review coming out this week. So go ahead and check out, see if you like it. And if you do, go to RathouseRETTHAUS.net.
Yeah.
And you will get 30% off your first box, which essentially just equals shipping and handling. You get shipping and handling and a little baby discount. Mm-hmm. It's okay. We're going to give away some stuff from there. So yeah, I'm having a baby.
What?
So I go to the second ultrasound. And this fucking kid.
Bigger dick than you?
I'll get into that. So we go to the ultrasound, right? And, dude, They do the gel thing and whatever, the ultrasound thing. And the kid,
but why do they put it on you?
Shut up. Shut up. Grey Jedi.
Fuck you.
The Pope?
Oh, I forgot to bring him. Oh. God damn it. I had it waiting too. All right, next week. Okay. Pope returns next week.
Pope returns. The return of the Pope.
Not the bigger Pope this time. Just for you, buddy.
The Vatican strikes back.
Okay, so let me fucking get into
the
story.
All right, so they got the jelly all over you.
No, shut up.
That's where we left off.
Grape or strawberry?
You know what? Maybe we should have a live studio in our audience. Yeah, I was gonna say it. They're going to town right now. And in fact, we're gonna turn up the outside mic, so hopefully it picks up more as well. So, like I was saying before I was rudely interrupted.
Yes, the jelly.
So
it puts the lotion on the skin.
Or else it gets the hose again. Exactly.
I fucking hate you guys.
So, you hate you guys? Come on, man. Jesus. Let's not go there.
Let's continue on. We got a show to fucking do. So they put the gel on and they use the ultrasound stuff. And this kid's like doing like flips and just like going to town, and I'm like, not yet. It's not even born. I don't. Calm down. Like, if you're doing this in the womb at 3 months, like Lord knows when you come out, you're like running around, flying around and shit.
Flying around.
Yeah, it's a demon. It's just gonna be
flying,
like,
swimming. Yeah.
We're gonna have it. We're gonna have Hunt for the Paranormal do exorcism on my child. Like, well, he's going to town, and they're and the
it's all for you,
and Damien. The nurse is like, what? Go to your kennel.
Okay.
Fine.
Hold on. We're gonna pause for one quick moment. Can the studio audience possibly open the door? Okay.
Hey! This is what happens when you bring your dog to the studio.
Bring your dog to work day.
Come here. Cameo time.
Ah, what are you doing? You go in front of the camera? Studio audience is fucking up today.
I can easily edit that out. Don't worry.
At least, no, keep it. So, they looked at my girlfriend and they're like, hey, what did you eat before coming in? And she's like, I had a banana and maybe like oatmeal and stuff. And I guess like maybe the sugar like hiked him up, or he's like really, really active. But that's how we found out at a very early time he rolled over to the left, and that's the nurse was like, "That's a penis right there." And we're like, "What?"
She pointing at you?
No.
We're like, no, yes, no. It is.
Hands down for some. I'm next, right?
Well, you're the one who got the jelly out.
Not lube. We're not doing a three-way here. What's going on?
Why does it say Astroglide?
Well, the funnier thing was, like, after that, my girlfriend jokingly was like, "And what a boy," you know, from The Simpsons when I think Maggie's born. And I go, "Yeah, that's not my side of the family. That must be yours." That's all I got to say about that. So, yeah, we saw a little schmeckle. And all I thought of was, do you remember Cluck at all? Where they go, like, "Hey, you know, my schmeckle got bigger." And they're like, "It couldn't get any tinier." It's like a little tic-tac.
Open your mouth. I'm brushing your breath.
That's all it made me think about. I was like, this is great. So, yeah, we have a name.
Oh, you have a name.
We have a name.
World premiere?
World premiere. Let's get a crowd clap on it. Elliot Thomas Bulgarin.
Elliot.
And eliminate the B. What's his initials? E.T. So now we're going to creep through. I want to buy like a life-size E.T. and just scare the shit out of him and have it in his room staring at him every day and like have it remote controlled. So it
does anyone in the studio audience have the number for Child Protective Services?
Hey, if the child's not here yet, you can't call shit, okay?
He's not even born and you're like, we can just scare the shit out of him.
We can just build that fence till then.
Hey, right. Hey.
It's not like this is all recorded.
It is. All right. This is what he plans to do to his child. Yeah, I'm excited. I don't get to play AFI to the child, which is already disappointing.
Why?
It is forbidden upon by the mother. So
smart gal.
No. I want to play Elliot Smith to the child too. She's like, what about some Bloodhound game? No suicidal music. And I was like, well, so we got into
it. Hey, that's assuming he actually commits suicide.
Yeah, who stabs herself twice in the heart? Mm-hmm. Just saying.
Old school, badass Japanese people.
It's called
people.
A metaphor. Yeah.
It's called a metaphor. No. It was physically.
Wait, AFI did that?
No.
Get the fuck out.
Yeah, Davey Havoc stabbed Elliot Smith. Although they did record in the same recording studio at one point. That's a true story. No, when Elliot Smith... by himself, just it's. I'm not gangster enough yet.
Street grit.
No, he didn't get shot 9 times. He shot himself with a shotgun, and just 9 pellets ended up going in.
No,
into
that
it.
Was Seal.
Was that before or after he kissed the rose?
It has to be before.
So, like we were saying, to answer your question, Aaron, Elliot Smith, when he quote-unquote committed suicide, it was 2 stabs to the heart. 2 stab wounds to the heart.
Way to go. That's
and I would understand if he had 2 9, but he's like, nope, not good enough! And then you do 1 more, it's just, no.
Guns are for pussies.
Tell that to Mike from the Paranormal Podcast.
Well, what's that compared to a guy who shot himself to a guy who stabbed himself twice in the heart who has more street cred?
Yeah, okay. That's what Elliot Smith was going for. He was like, you know, it'd be gangster as hell. Yeah. Elliot, you're not into that type of style. You know, it'd be gangster as hell. Just stab myself twice. Yes, that's good.
I stapled my hand before.
I've glued my fingers together. Does that count? Do I get street cred for that?
I didn't even pull it out like the right way. Yanked it out and it ripped my hand. And I also got a good little lighter happy face.
Oh, you got a germs burn?
Yeah.
Germs burn?
Yeah. Yes. Well, I did. It was a drunken pact of nothing.
Oh, I did some stupid stuff when I was young too. Anyways, from this moment on, I guess every week will be baby watch, and we will see how far and what's going on with the baby.
Yeah, don't.
He's
go
got
to,
a great heartbeat.
Don't go to schools and say that.
What? This is a segment on my show.
I'd be like,
baby
I'm
watch.
Gonna have a child.
I want to see.
That's why I'm creepily walking around the school right now.
Don't they like candy?
They'll be like, grown 28-year-old Matthew Bulgarin was arrested today, creepily walking around an elementary school, saying, "Why don't the kids have enough candy?" I'll be on with the Cluck News. It'll be awesome, man. You guys will be able to read it.
You have the same definition of awesome.
And the semi-downfall of Rat House.
I like how it's just a bump. We it's not the entire downfall. It's like, no.
Oh, it's because we're not fully up there yet.
All right, so let's go. Let's continue going around. Patrick.
What up?
You got to see a band recently.
Yes. Fucking Mouse Rat. It's the greatest band in the world. Hey,
what the fuck?
Oh, no.
What is that? Is that our logo?
No.
Is that our logo?
It's a...
No.
That's wait, a, what's a mouse
it's
rat?
It's actually not that far off. I never really thought about that.
I did when I saw it. I was like, that's really close.
Is it a mouse? So if it's a mouse...
Uh-huh. It's inside.
It's inside. And when it's a rat, it's outside.
Yeah.
So does that mean when a mouse goes outside, is it a rat? And if a rat goes inside, is it a mouse?
Different species.
Scary movie.
A mouse and a rat.
No, you're ruining the joke.
Oh, it's a joke.
Oh, well, in that case.
Yeah, go ahead. Go into Chaos Quickies. Yeah, good job. Good job. Good job. You didn't even try to go for a blue. You
went is it blue?
Blues are sound effects.
That's your joke right there.
I'm going to release everything that you told me prior to this damn podcast. No, but go on. You got to see... Now, I always get confused. Is it American football or modern baseball? Which one is it?
Modern. What the fuck is modern baseball?
Okay, so... I knew it was one of them. I knew it was one of them.
There's usually...
No, there's a...
Pitcher, batter...
There's a band called Modern Baseball, and then there's another band called American Football.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. It's the with the designated hitter rule.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, right. Yeah, no, it's not baseball season yet.
You have the Raiders versus the Ducks.
Asking for death right now, aren't you?
I'm going to end up quitting the show this week anyway, so... You can't fire me! No, I saw American Football last night, and...
Should we get into one of their songs?
Yeah.
What song would you like to hear?
You know what? Just randomize that shit.
I can't, because I always hear this... I only hear one song from fucking the French-Canadian. French-Canadian. What's that album called? Wow.
American Football.
It's just self-titled?
Yeah.
Yep.
I did not know that. All right, so go on, man.
So that album came out probably 20-plus years ago.
Is it that old?
And then they quit playing. I never saw them when they were together then. They got back together a couple years ago to do some shows, and of course somehow I missed it. And then I think as a result of touring together, decided to do a second album.
Well, it took fucking 20 years to get that second album out.
I'm looking forward to the third album, which should be out somewhere around 2037.
Oh, man. So American Football.
Yeah.
Why are they called American Football?
I'm not in the band. I don't know. Ask them. Let's get them on. Can you do it?
Of course. We could totally.
Kind of pull you guys.
We could totally do that. Shit out of my. First? Which one's the first album? 1999. Damn, really? That was that long ago.
All right. 18 years. I was thinking 20.
And don't they have like horns and stuff in their band too?
The drummer plays trumpet.
At the same time? Like.
Yes. It was a pretty interesting setup where the bassist had a drum in front of him. So at one point he started playing the drums.
Wait, are you joking with me then?
He had one drum. Yeah. Hold on, I gotta tune out now.
So this is a little taste of American.
This is that, I think this is what they closed with last night. The
place never meant.
Bonkers. For a bunch of old guys sitting in chairs, it went bonkers.
I don't care much for the vocalist.
I don't think he cares much for you. There we go.
So that's a wee little taste of
not bad.
American football. Yeah. American football. American. Are that you know it's kind of dangerous to be an American now in Trump's America. Do you think they might change the name to like
French Canadian
not
football?
Trump American football? Like, do you think they'll switch it to that at all? Or is that the next album? Like, And they're all white in that band, right? It's already yeah. dangerous
or
as it is.
Or they'll just get that orange tan.
Oh, God. Is that washable, like that tan? Or does it dye permanently for like a few months? Yeah, it's funny because he went in.
To throw that guy in a pool just
dude,
to see
Trump went in. Trump went in orange as shit and came out like pale as fuck. Like and he got scared straight or something. He's like, holy shit.
And now that
I'm gonna die.
Now that he's all wrinkly and shit too, he looks like the like ruffled cheddar.
Yeah. Oh, so how long was the set list of American football?
They played for an hour and a half.
Get the fuck out of here.
They only have two albums, so and
they basically played both of them. Yeah, that's what it sounds like. They played everything in its entirety.
I think what they did. Covers. I think they played the new album front to back. I think they played it in order. I'm not 100% sure. And then they took a quick, they said, we're going to take a break. And all these people got up to go smoke. And they literally came back like 1 minute later. So
that was a break. They're like, who's got to poop and who's got to pee? I got to go like hell, man.
They played like a couple, one or two tracks from like an EP they put out. And then they went into stuff from the first album. They didn't play the entire first album, although I wish they did. But I think they did like five or six. It was amazing.
When I went to go see Touche Amore once,
I thought he was gonna say if I.
No, I went to go see Touche Amore once, and they played the technically the first and second album front to back, mm-hmm. and everyone's all encore, and they're we played everything. What do you want? And so they ended up doing some B side stuff. Mm-hmm. They're like, all right, like we'll do like maybe three or four songs from EPs. So that's why I figured if maybe they conquered everything. Do they even have any EPs at all?
Yeah, they played I think two songs from a three song EP, I think.
Nice.
Like right in between. So they almost kind of went backwards in time. I saw another band, one of my favorite bands called Slint, and it was the first time I got to see them. It was the same idea. They had gotten back together for this some company was like sponsoring this thing where broken up bands would get back together and play one of the whatever their iconic album was front to back, and that was the whole
nice.
show. But their biggest record, or the one that I think is the most popular, only had six songs. So they did the six songs, then they played two songs off of an EP, and then we're thinking, okay, I guess that's it. And they said, all right, here's a new one. What the fuck? So that kind of gave me hope that they were gonna do more stuff, but I don't think they ever recorded or released it as far as I know.
That's disappointing. So would you suggest people to check out American Football?
If you can, yeah, because, I mean, it's going to be, what, another 18 years?
Did they only do this one little tour and that was it?
No, they did a...
I thought they played last year.
It was I think, maybe 2 years ago. They did, like, three dates or something, and that was it. And I thought that would be it. And I don't know how I missed it. I just remember being at home watching TV and, like, looking on Instagram and seeing that some of my friends were watching American Football Live. I'm like, fuck! How did I miss this?
That's what happened when H2... Remember when H2O played? And yeah. I was like, how did I miss that they were playing over here?
So
You told me about that before, though. You're like, oh, I'm going to go see him. I'm like, dude, if you haven't seen him, go watch him.
No, I was going to go to I was going to go to New York. And then I missed that Friday show and I was going to drive to San Francisco.
So I had... They I think originally were going to play this... When they announced this, if you want to call it a tour.
Tour.
Originally, I think it was three dates, Chicago, New York, LA. And so I bought a ticket for New York because I was originally planning to be out there that weekend.
Yeah.
And then a conference I had to go to that I assumed was the weekend before turned out was that weekend, so I had to cancel. So I thought, okay, I'm going to miss them again.
Yeah.
Because when they announced ticket sales, it's like Chicago went on sale, New York went on sale, and the LA one was kind of like TBD. I'm like, something's going to happen, and I'm going to miss it. I'm going to find out it sold out. So I better just buy the New York one to be safe. Then by the time I found out I can't go to New York, I was kind of assuming that LA was sold out. And luckily I checked, and I ended up getting, I guess everybody wanted to be cheap and pay $9 less to not sit in the front couple rows.
What?
So when I went on, I just bought, it's a, you know, nicest ticket, and it was second
front row. Front row, dead center. Oh, yeah. Okay.
It was an extra,
I guess I'm going to that.
Extra $9?
Yeah.
People are cheap, but.
You know,
it was worth it. It was well worth the extra $9.
That reminds me of this band that I'm about to play now. They're called Rain, R-A-E-I-N. And they kind of put out albums when they want to and decide to play when they want to. And even though they're signed, it's just like, yeah, when we get to it.
Yeah.
And this is off their like third or fourth album. You could barely like find any of their stuff. It's like really rare to even find copies of stuff. But this song is called Blue Lines by Rain. You know what it really seems like? It seems like a lot of like the 90s emo bands like came and left. Like maybe like Page 99 or Orchid and stuff like that. They just came and released two albums and were like, yeah, okay, well, we did it, and just kind of walked away.
Yeah,
it's really
no idea
weird.
Who they are.
Speaking of some hardcore bands and oh, punk bands, yeah, and emo bands, Rev Fest is coming up this week when this releases. Tickets will already be on sale. You got Bold, Gorilla Biscuits, Civ.
Into Another.
Death by Stereos covering Inside Out for a complete set. Judge, Youth of Today. So
Into Another.
Oh, and that other band, Into Another?
Into Another is playing too. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the only one that matters.
You know what? I also heard Into Another's playing.
Yes, yes, they are.
Give us so a little, when they say into another, do they mean like into another?
That's all you ever think about,
right?
I mean,
what got you in trouble in the first place?
Hey, at the age of 27, I'm not doing too bad. I ain't doing too bad. Jose,
what?
You're a scruffy Nerf Herder.
Hey, who's scruffy looking?
Yeah, you could have a fucking conversation. You can.
Oh,
this is your segue.
What the fuck do you want me to say?
Well, you went somewhere and you made me put up the CD for
I didn't make you do shit. You just did that on your
fucking
own.
Fucking lying sack of shit. Anyway, so where'd you go, dude?
Slide Bar, downtown Fullerton. Nerf Herder was playing there for free.
Who's Nerf Herder?
Nerf Herder, they're a band. I think they came out with the first album in 2003, I believe.
Are they herding Nerfs?
No.
Do they take Nerf guns to their concert?
No, but that'd be fucking awesome.
I don't want to see them fucking.
They take good. They take good vibes and hilarious songs.
So we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna get into song. But continue on. Tell us about the show, man.
It was pretty awesome. They had two bands before them. The first band was literally their name was No Explanation. They weren't bad. They're okay. they're
that's
better
the
than
stamp
what
of approval right there.
Well,
that's your band. Well, you're not bad.
Well, if okay. If I was Matt explaining who they are, I'd be like, okay, well. They're not AFI, so they suck.
That's not true at all.
Or, no, he would
or
say...
Or they're not Nickelback.
They're not as good as AFI.
He'd say, their music kind of reminds me of like AFI's third album, but not so much their fourth album, because that's when he had like the vest.
The fact that you're not wrong is the sad. Like, technically, you'd be like, yeah, well, from the third to fourth album changed, so eat a dick. Anyways, go on.
Yeah, the second band was Downtown Brown. They were pretty fucking good. They're really lively.
Downtown Brown.
Fuck yeah. Check them out. They're pretty awesome. It was out there, man. The second band was out there, but they're fucking dope.
Some Nerf Herder. This song's called Sorry. Mm-hmm.
It's fucking good, too. I love it.
This reminds me of like Lagwagon. Who's the one that sings Disco Face to Face? MXPX. Reminds me of like that mainstream era of punk rock.
It was good, man. They have some great songs. Like my buddy turned me on to them a while ago.
You like Green Day too, huh? You're a big Green Day fan, so this is like right up your alley.
Not big Green Day fan, but yeah, I do.
I thought you're a big Green Day fan.
No, not a huge. Well, older shit.
Well, there is something unpredictable. And in the end, I think it's right.
Damn right. You know what I mean.
Hope you had the time of your life at that show.
Let's it go. Was all right. Apparently, you're a big Green Day fan.
Put up the boss joke. I need to push buttons after that.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. What are you going to get?
Whoa. Jesus. What the hell was that?
That was your fault.
Fighting me with feedback so I can't get it. All right, I'll stay right there.
That's all I gotta say. So let's go ahead. You guys know what time it is.
Do we?
It's time for What the Cluck News.
Oh, fuck. I thought you were gonna say Tom Thanks. I'm like, there's no way it's time for Tom Thanks.
No, definitely
we didn't
not
do Tom Thanks last time.
What
so
the Cluck News.
We gotta do two this time.
So, okay, so you guys got a choice to which one you want to go first.
One.
Okay, one. Oh, you're gonna do this to me? All right, I see how it is.
You can't complain if you give us a choice and then we pick one and you're like, I don't
no,
want to
no,
do
no,
that
no,
one.
Not
then you
that.
Pick next time.
No, I'm clicking on the link and it's not like...
Clicking on the link. Apple phone sucks. Oh,
yes, I'm clicking on the link. All right, here we go. You guys just stop! Oh gosh, this is hilarious. I'm so sorry. And I'm just laughing, thinking about this. What the hell is going on here?
Every time, dude, lift up your headphone.
Jesus.
Told you. This fucking mic is hot.
No, no, no. You're just a little loud.
I'm just, you know what?
There you go. I turned you down a little bit.
No,
I,
that one was mine.
Do you
that
have
time.
Your
that was mine that time.
Okay. That well, shit was, don't take wow. them off, people. All right.
Fuck. Yeah, the best reaction, though.
Guys are ridiculous. All right, here we go. Ready?
One third of our studio audience is outside when that happened and they missed it.
Okay. Guys,
a whole
ready?
Group of people laughed and came back.
Guys, ready? This has to, okay, right, so ready. Let's take guesses real quick.
It's a pen.
It has to do with the judge.
Judy.
Dredd. Wapner. Ito.
Pointless.
They took all the judges I knew.
It has to do with a judge.
Brown.
Okay, so you guys ready? Blake Jefferson cried and heaved with emotion as he... As he made his initial court appearance Monday morning, the Texas judge could be seen laughing at Jefferson when he screamed out, "I don't want to get raped! I don't want them to fuck me! They gonna fuck me!" The judge took no mercy on Jefferson.
And raped him.
who was being charged in the stabbing and death of his mother. As he was let out in handcuffs, he sobbed and doubled over, and then put his hands over his heart and cried more as he signed the court documents. The problem was is that every time he signed, like water just got on it, so they kept making him sign other documents.
While he's getting raped.
He could be heard mumbling his... He could be heard mumbling, "My ass gonna be on fire."
He ain't lying.
Oh, man. Why would I? Okay, like, when you hear that, like, I've heard, like, people that get in trouble for, like, statutory rape, mm-hmm. when you go to jail, like, you're gonna get it because that could be someone's son or daughter on the outside. Mm-hmm. I don't know about murdering your mother if that's more of a
I would think it would be on
a
the line
butt
of that,
thingy.
Yeah.
No. Usually, no, but if someone is in, locked up for being like a child molester or rape, it's not that they get raped in prison; it's they usually get killed. Like
it's
raped and then killed.
Take them out. Well,
it's guilt-free murder for them.
Like, they rape them with sense. They Gaddafi them.
To them, they're doing something good. They're just getting rid of trash.
Okay, this is like the worst hair day of all time. Yesterday, God. Oh, yes.
Checking.
Yesterday. Photo of a woman sitting in an Eastern European hospital room, started to circulate on the internet. According to the reports, she accidentally mistook builder's foam for hair mousse. So yes, now she has a big old helmet of foam all her head. You know, like the giant foam stuff that they put to like insulate. Yeah. She used that as hair mousse. It started doing her hair, and it expanded.
Why did I just picture, like, the old, like, fucking George Washington, like, wigs, like, the powdered wigs?
She just like molded it to that. Like this is a good look.
Chia pet.
Really good look.
It dries, like, yellow, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Maybe she wants to go for that dirty blonde look.
Yes. Now she has a big old helmet hair of foam on her head. And all the information was given surrounding this photo, and they show the photo. Then again, if a picture of a painting says 1,000 words, this one could have been summed up in a few. So,
what were the few words?
Foam head.
You can make it up.
I'll continue it on. It says, now if you look carefully at the photo, you'll notice that some leaves and twigs are in the foam. Perhaps there was more leaves to the story than what she passed on the internet, but I can't say. So there you go, man. That's your
What the
Cluck
the
news.
Cluck.
Okay. Yeah.
Sorry.
That you did that on purpose.
No, that
you
one I
did that,
one
that on messed. Purpose.
I'm always fidgeting with my headphones.
We need to get you the little box.
The fidgety thing?
Yeah.
The
fidget
box. Oh, who did that?
Really? I need you guys to be more professional, guys.
Came out of his ass.
Oh, it doesn't make it any better when you fucking say it out loud, does it, producer?
I think they prefer.
That's it, producer. Thanks, appreciate it.
Oh, okay.
So we're gonna...
Way to flip it, Trump.
Hey, in all fairness, I'm delivering a shit ton of fake news, so you can kiss my ass.
Oh, we're going to call you Fox News then.
Oh, man. So Old Man Logan's coming out.
Yeah.
Isn't it just called Logan?
Well, yeah, it is. And there's a reason why. And you can find my article at thathashtagshow.com to see exactly why it is probably called Logan rather than Old Man Logan. Says in comments
after dark.
You're right, it's not, but geeks are still on here, and that's why we talk about Star Wars.
No, we talk about Star Wars because it's amazing.
Yeah.
So, you guys, it's been a while.
It's been a while.
It's that time for hashtag Tom Things. And this week, I'm thankful for actually walking in today, turning on the TV, and Captain Phillips was on. And getting to hear from one of... And getting to hear from one of...
He's Captain.
Getting to hear from one of our... I'm going to kick your ass. From one of our partners on Rat House, we actually heard that he was deployed and was actually close to the ship when everything was going down for Captain Phillips. Unfortunately, he didn't get to save Captain Phillips, a.k.a. Tom Hanks, but, you know, close enough. So, there you go. That is my...
Oh, I was waiting on you. Dude, we're going and fucking
don't put that shit on me. You're next.
Gator don't pay no shit.
It's like when you're spanking the kids and like you're the second one in line. You're like, I don't even want to be here. Can we switch? It's like, it's not going to be any better, dude. You had a Tom Thanks 2 weeks ago.
I know, and then we didn't do it.
Thank you, Tom.
See?
For almost making it to the moon.
Apollo 13?
Nice. Damn right.
Nice.
Yeah, I know.
It's you, bro.
Yeah.
It's right. You.
You said you were going to pump out two.
Yo, two?
You said you were going to pump out two.
What about our studio audience?
They don't
fuck
do
them.
Tom things.
Thank you, Tom, for showing Americans not to stand there and bitch and wait for someone else to solve their problems. Put your mind to it and reverberate around the room.
What?
You know how we got
He tried to make really, like, a philosophical thing go down.
No, well, I was adding to the... Or what's the word I was looking for? To slingshot around the moon like they did in that movie.
Yeah, slingshot.
So he was just right there. It's hard to do it when you're on the spot, right?
What's the thing where they slingshot around the moon? Slingshot around the moon.
Well,
that's
what I
it.
Meant.
That's what
that's
it is.
That's the
one. I was thinking bounce and I said reverberate, yeah.
Thanks, Tom, for making Patrick... slip up on today's show.
Oh, dude. That is the way we are leaving. On a high note.
Thanks, Tom, for having a friend in me.
That's not his friend, if you know what I mean.
That's not even his song.
No matter.
He was in the movie.
Who's the annoying guy? You got a friend in me.
Randy Newman.
Yeah, right. Took a bite from the apple.
Took one bite. Took two bite. You know what? I can't do it. Guys, make sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter at @thatslife_pod. You can always call into the podcast at 714-684-1652. Give your Tom thanks for whatever you want to talk about. I'm your host, I'm Tiara. I'm Matt Threaten, as always.
Thanks, Tom.
He just has a vendetta now because he couldn't think of one. Fuck you, Tom. Fuck you.
Oh!
What?
Oh!
What?
We don't talk like that on this show.
What?
I hope Tom Hanks bitch slaps you with a goddamn typewriter.
Yeah.
I think Kurt Russell should come.
Just should come?
Should come over. That's it.
That's it? That's all you want?
Yep.
I mean, I can make that happen for you.
Later.